taxes tonight, and I just got to get through with it. Thank you so much for all of the experience. Where are we in the...
Yeah.
You put that in there, that's right.
Oh, yeah.
I have to climb the thing I got.
Ah!
Put your jacket on.
No. I
kingdom in our hands, in the chapter 2, that's the dream, and again, no interpreter. Any promotion, and help to the position, and worship someone. Almost what they got. He's so impressed. Now, but he recognizes that God is powerful. no real belief. But now, we write in chapter 4, it's like, God is real. Nebuchadnezzar rested. And yes, he flourished in his house. He had no desire or wants, and he snatched a stranger, and he had whatever he wants. I saw a dream that made me afraid, and thoughts upon my bed and visions in my head that troubled me. Therefore, I made a decree to bring all the wise men of Babylon before me, that they might make known to me the interpretation of the dream. Just like we talked about before, the magicians, the astrologers, and the Chaldeans, and the soothsayers. Four different groups. They all have different ways to figure out the truth. Study stars, look at nature, look at the crystal ball, and that kind of thing. I told them the dream, and they couldn't tell me what it meant. At last, Daniel came in before me. Why didn't he take him first? No. His name was Belshazzar. According to the name of my God, Belshazzar. So he wanted to give him the name of God. And he is the spirit of the Holy God. Notice what he calls him here. Position. because I know that the Spirit of the Lord God is in me. Now, secret, tell me the visions of the dream that I have seen and the interpretation. There are visions in my head in the bed, and I saw all the trees in the earth, and it was a very great time. This word watcher, the Holy One from heaven. That is the only time in the Bible this word is used. Watcher. Most of the Bibles are written in two languages. You know what? Really was more of one of the old Greek visions. In Greek came the little letters. During the Roman Empire, there was still a Greek language. Not Latin. It was not spoken much, but in writing, it was mostly. Greek was spoken and written worldwide. Later, now what is the world language? English. Yet today, every political leader knows English. Knows how to read and write. Because it's the commerce language. There are a few others. But primarily. Others, French, Spanish, and Greek, and before Greek, Aramaic. They're spoken by people of Babylon, Egypt. chapter 4, is really chapter 3, 4, 5, and 6, are all written in Aramaic. Very interesting. This word. Verse number 13, watch. What does it mean? It was being deluxed. Really, the word angelos means messenger. Well, it's very much the same. We assume he. So in the dream, he sees an angel from heaven. Well, what does the angel do? Verse 14. And cried aloud. Yeah, here it is. Go ahead and read. Cut down the tree. Cut off the branches. Shake off the leaves and scatter the fruit. Let the beasts get away from under it and the fowls from its branches. Nevertheless, leave the stump of his roots. Even with a band of iron and brass in the tender grass of the field. Let it be wet with the dew from heaven. And let his portion be with the beasts in the grass of the earth. Let his heart be changed from man, and let a beast's heart be given unto him. And let seven times pass over him. And the poor woman, bring back up there. Let's make sure you understand. Number one, the word heaven. He's used it 3 times now. Not the capital H heaven. The dew of heaven. There are 3 heavens. Most people would say. Heaven with a capital H is signed this way. The universe, space, stars, and the third heaven would be the atmosphere. You know, the dew comes down and stays on grass. That's what we're talking about. So this is just some artist renderings of what they thought the picture looked like. He just stood there. Did he quote his friend? He stood there for now. That's what it says.
Belshazzar,
come on, tell me. Don't let that be.
just understand, King. It's not what you saw, the tree that you saw, which grew in the storm, whose height reached into the heaven, and the sight thereof, all the earth, whose leaves were bare, and the fruit thereof much. And it, meat for all, under which the beast of the field dwelt, and upon his branches, the fowls of the heaven had their habitation. It's you, King. Why did he tell you that? Because the king has great control. Almost all of the known world at that time. Most everything was under that Babylonian Empire. So you have become great, strong. And reach unto the heavens and thy dominion to the end of the earth. But you saw that angel come down and destroy the tree.
Oh,
I have to let you know something's going to happen to you. So 7 years.
When
was that? Until you know that the Most High God ruleth the kingdom of men and gives it to whomever he wants. Why were they commanded to leave the stump? Because the kingdom will be given back to you. And you shall have known that the heavens do rule. Notice, Daniel doesn't say, save my life. He doesn't say, spare me. He says, wherefore, stop sinning. Get right with God, your mistakes and sins, stop. Show mercy to the poor. And it may lengthen your peace. This is a warning. The king died just says, okay, thanks Daniel, your peace. And it all happened to him.
At the end of
12 months, he walked in the palace of the kingdom of Babylon.
Woo!
Babylon is great. I am hot stuff. House of the kingdom by the power of my majesty. The word is in the king's mouth. That instant, a voice from heaven saying, King Nebuchadnezzar, as it was spoken to thee, the kingdom is departed from thee.
Down.
he heard the voice from heaven. No, he doesn't die. But he is driven away from them. And your dwelling shall be with the beasts of the field. You shall eat grass like oxen, and seven times shalt thou pass over thee. And so now Most High will open the kingdom of men and give to him whosoever he will. The same hour was the thing fulfilled upon Nebuchadnezzar, and he was driven from men and did eat grass like oxen. And his body was wet with the dew of heaven, till the hairs were grown like eagle's feathers and his nails like birds' claws. What does that mean? So here's picture the artist.
Yeah. He's big
in his claws. Picture related to the vision. No, it really happened. That really happened as documented. That happened to Nebuchadnezzar. In the next verse, he lost his mind. He becomes crazy. End of the days, I, Nebuchadnezzar, lifted up mine eyes unto heaven, and my understanding returned to me, and I blessed the Most High. And I praised and honored him that liveth forever, whose dominion is an everlasting dominion, and his kingdom is from generation to generation. And all the inhabitants of the earth are nothing. And he does according to his will in the army of heaven and among the inhabitants of the earth. And none can stay his hand or say unto him, what do you do? At the same time, how long? King James Version says seven times passed. What does seven times mean? Most people think 7 years. And I agree with that interpretation. Other people say, 7 months. 7 times of the moon phases. That's not long enough. In my opinion, it was 7 years. There's really two options. I prefer the 7 years versus the 7 months. Well. And at the same time, my reason returned unto me, and for the glory of my kingdom, my honor and brightness returned unto me. And my counselors and my lords sought on me, and I was established in my kingdom. And excellent majesty was added unto me. Now I, Nebuchadnezzar, praise and extol and honor the King of heaven, whose works are true, and his ways judgment, and those that walk in pride he is able to abase. Why did I like chapter 4 so much? He honors God, but more than that, I believe that Nebuchadnezzar is safe. And why do you think I believe in that? A few reasons. One, his words. He praises the Most High God. Does he become a Jew? No, I don't believe that he adopts Jewish culture, but he accepts God as his king. I truly believe that. And also, the principle of right in the Bible. Who are the writers of the New Testament? The holy men of God, moved and inspired by God. How can Nebuchadnezzar write? I believe he's saved, that he has become holy and he will be in heaven. I think it's cool. One of the only few Gentile believers of the Old Testament. I had no relation to Israel prior. It's strong encouragement for you and I. We gather as church. I call it the Holy Huddle. You know, football huddle? Hop around, make sure nobody else can see. Then we line up and go. Right? So we like the whole film. We don't go out a lot and share with others. We don't have many opportunities to give to other people, but I believe Daniel showed through his life the power of God, especially to Nebuchadnezzar. And Nebuchadnezzar saw these examples and said, I accept, I believe it. So I suffered and became humble. And some people say, no. And many people just say, I blame God for all these things that happened. It happens to me. And Nebuchadnezzar, he could have done that, but he knew. He knew who was the right God. He knew there were a lineup of little g gods and one Most High God. It's a very cool story. Yep. In chapter 4, hold on. That's all he wrote. Yep. Chapter 1, 2, and 3, Daniel. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Then chapter 4 is the only one written in the New Testament. The king himself looked like that in the picture, and he went back to being normal. Yeah, it happened that way. He was this way for 7 years, then he surrendered and changed and went back to being a king. Yes, yeah. That's right. Born did the Lord have son? I don't know. It doesn't talk about son. Talks about a grandson. About What? You want to read chapter 5? Go ahead.
Oh, God.
Sure.
No!
You bad boy. Any other questions? I agree 1,000% that God can elevate a man or take him down. Just like that, in an instant. And it's important for us, as men, especially those in leadership roles, to remain humble. Especially for me as pastor, I really have to be humble. And to be honest, I work hard to be humble. Why? Because I don't want to fight him today. Without the whole Bible, pride leads to destruction. And I don't want that for me or my family and my church. But not Nebuchadnezzar to save and thwart. He saw it in me. I believe he saved that. His son never finished. He came back to his right mind and he never stood. From then on, I believe that he was saved after that point. And that's why he put down the story to tell other people, hey, don't let pride get in the way. You need to honor the Most High God. He realized through the interpretations and being a beast, that experience of losing his mind really hit him like a 2x4. And I mean, he looked like a bear, and he had grass, hay, you know, whatever. And he walked around naked for 7 years. That's enough to convince me. I don't need 7 years, I need to listen to 2 days. Yeah. Horrible pause. You know, he's already dark skinned in the Middle Eastern. Honest, Nebuchadnezzar doesn't really help the Jews a lot. Babylon will be defeated soon. In 2 weeks, you're going to see that. Not really next week. Babylon will hold. You know, the golden head, remember that part? And then the Medo-Persian, the silver part, and that's going to be coming soon. There. Artaxerxes. And they're going to send, he's going to send Israel back home. About 150 to 200 years for the first time, and then 400 to come back again, second time. So the first time, Ezra builds a temple, and then they go back to build the wall. And then allow the people of Israel to go back to Israel. Altogether, I think about 200 years, if I get all that right. Nebuchadnezzar and Babylon don't go to the Jews. But promoted Daniel and elevated him with control. But he didn't suppress them into slavery like the Egyptians did. But he did. He was good to them and promoted them, but we don't know how long after the story. After Nebuchadnezzar dies, his grandson is the next king. And we will see but how long it happened after this, I'm not sure. It's a relatively short period of time. So after that, Nebuchadnezzar dies, and his grandson takes over. He doesn't do well. You're going to see that in chapter 5. Some questions? Really communism, you know, interesting. Let me go back. Why can't I go back? Oh, there, now it works. Okay. Oop. It's normal for kings to grab as much as land as they could and conquer as many people as they could. Solomon did the same thing. David did the same thing. Moses really didn't. So Joshua actually led him to the promised land. Saul had some help from David, and Saul really enlarged it. So is that communism? No, we just call it a kingdom, you know, an area where they rule an empire. The word empire means multiple countries under one rule. For a while, Israel, in the Middle East, Israel had quite a bit of control, but it was such a short time frame. and they split apart, and came back, and then Egypt had something to do with it. Egypt had a lot of control over the gathering of the kingdom. And then Babylon, and he split. And Israel falls, and soon after that, Egypt becomes under and has to be captive to Babylon. And Babylon had humongous control, but it's not communism. Now, I think in the 1800s, they had control of India, parts of Africa, around the whole world, around the globe, had English control. Was that communism? Most of the time, colonialism, it's called, and they oppress the people where they take over control. They want natural resources. You know, America did the same thing, the same way. You know, Puerto Rico, we've done that to Puerto Rico, and some other areas. In the Pacific Islands to Guam, Hawaii, yes. It's not called communism, it's taking
control. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Communism is, you have to follow everything on the rules. And most of the time, Babylon took over and still let them worship their own gods in the different countries. They did come in and say, you know, you have to follow us, you know, like Hitler or Russia or Stalin, you know. These different things up in China, you know. Do we have different communities? You talk about China. That's the idea. So today America has states, you know, they're under the American government, technically similar to Babylon, because Babylon controlled many states and countries. And recognize and admit you have the ability and power. Lord, I don't want to take control. Absolutely not. I want to be home. I don't want to be home. I don't ever want to say, look at this kingdom. I go, oh, please look at what I'm going to say. knew that my work in the things I do. You are the wise, you are the seed, you are worthy. Lord, be with us as we go home. Help us, give us comfort and peace in our hearts.